So we came up with a very innovative model that is based on progressive education. If some of you are interested to understand the roots of this education that was created at the end of the 19th century. And the idea behind this education is that you should learn, should not learn just for the sake of learning something, right? If we go back centuries ago, we were just learning books, just memorizing books, right? But today that doesn't make sense. So we have no teachers, no formal teachers, right? You're like, what? A school without teacher? What kind of hell is that, right? Like, if you imagine teacher, like, yeah, sitting in the chair, listening to the teacher, looking at the whiteboard, right? That's probably how all of you have been educated. Well, we have no teachers, we have no lectures, and you don't pay. Yeah, the school is free. The school is free up to when students find a job. So the idea is that we want to align the school's success and student success. If they succeed, we succeed. If they fail, we fail. We have skin in the game. The other thing that we are leveraging is community, right? So teachers are experts, but they used to be experts, or they are academic experts. But let's take the example of software engineers. Are they truly software engineer experts? Probably not, right? They're in education, not in software engineering. So we work with software engineers to make sure that the curriculum is constantly up to date, that students are learning concepts, tools that they can use right after the program. The community is also here to make sure that students who have nothing to do with software engineering prior to coming to the program can understand what it's like to be a software engineer. How do you get ready for technical interview? What happens when you are a woman in the tech industry? And that what it's like to work for a startup, for a big company. And the last thing that we are relying on is software. One of the two main pillars of the mission of Holberton School is to provide high-quality education to the most. So the first pillar, high-quality education, is provided by this piece. So students learn by working in groups on projects. So instead of listening passively to a lecture, we give students projects. Okay, it starts very simple. We give them guidance, and they learn by working on it, collaborating with their peers. In regular education, if you help your peer, it's called cheating, right? But in the workplace, it's called collaboration. It's just essential. We want teams. We don't want individuals to be working well. And so the second part is accessibility. Accessibility is through the fact that students don't need to pay anything. And the second piece is through the software-driven application process, meaning that there is no human selecting the students. It's software-based. This way, we make sure that there is no discrimination and no human bias. So we are a two-year program, and we are indeed not a boot camp. A boot camp is generally a few months training on few tools, one or two tools, usually retraining, right? It's like usually people who are mid-career, maybe more advanced in their career, they want to upscale or get into a new career. We are more like an alternative to college. We are full stack. I won't get too much in detail into this, but we want students to have solid foundation to become great software engineers, not just learn one or two tools that will get them a job that's probably not highly paid. And when these tools are changing, they are completely lost because it just learned these few tools. The key of this education is not to learn tools, it's to learn how to learn, to become a problem solver, critical thinkers, and having this foundation that will help you to grow in your career. So, what are the advantages of using this methodology? I will speak here for us, but also for the students. So it's cheaper because we have no formal teachers. We use software as much as we can. And basically, we can grow very aggressively. Right? Like the quality of our education is not relying on teachers. It's relying on a community which can scale, on a methodology which can scale, on software, and it can scale as well. For students, it's faster, right? Like a regular university is 5 years, and it's mostly theory-based. You don't learn much. you like absorb, you are supposed to absorb knowledge, but software engineering is a craft. It's like making bread. Let's say you want to make bread. You can read all the books about bread that you want, watch a TV show, try to make bread. It's gonna be terrible, right? Probably. So you need to make bread to understand, oh, I need more salty or temperature here and there. It's the same for software. You need to practice it. So students come up better prepared, and also they are stronger on the long term, right? Because today they learned C, Python, JavaScript, whatever you want. But tomorrow they will need to learn something new. What it is, I don't really know. But I know the last panel was AI, machine learning, right? So AI will replace software engineering in some capacity. How, we don't really know, but the job is going to change. So learning how to learn is just essential. So what we achieved since 2016 when we opened the school, we opened with 30 students. And what happened after 9 months is that students were getting jobs at LinkedIn, NASA, and Dropbox, and so we were like, wow, looks like we're onto something. So we scaled up. Last year, we helped 100 students. And our students are getting jobs. They are getting jobs, and we help a type of people that usually universities don't want. So a lot of people who are not strong financially, who are not good at school, we have a quite diverse group of students, about 35% women, which in the tech industry is unseen. The age goes from 18 to 58. It's never too late to start a new career. Half of our students are non-white. It's a big topic in the US. Most software engineers look like me, white dude with a beard. And students are getting published and are talking at a bunch of tech conferences. So it's not only technical skills, it's also soft skills, right? Can you share with the community? Can you do public speaking, technical writing? Can you help your peers? Can you empower other people to do their job better? Students love it. That's something that we are really trying to work on is the experience at the school. It's not because it's a free school that it should be bad, right? And students spend anywhere from 8 to 10 hours a day at the school. Sometimes every day, including weekends, for the first few months, it's tough. But we have a lot of tweets are like, yeah, it's the first time in my life I like going to school. And when you see this, you're like, score, we are doing something well. But managers love it as well. We have a bunch of companies from very early stage. I've seen students joining a one-person startup with not even funding. Some of our students are creating companies. Some are joining the best companies in the Valley. And that actually speaks volumes. That's why also we started in Silicon Valley. Because if we can train students for Apple, Tesla, NASA, and so on, chances are that we can train software engineers for any company in the world. The tech companies in the Valley are probably among the best, so the bar to hire is like very high. So what's next for us? We just took over a new location in San Francisco that will allow us to enroll 500 students per year, which means that it's going to be a campus of 1,000 students. Just to give you an idea of the scale compared to the rest of the U.S. market for like software engineer training, the largest universities in the U.S. are training about 800 students per year. Those are like sometimes it's a century-old institution. So within the span of 3 years, we managed to get at their scale, serving students that they usually don't want to serve because they don't have the money, maybe they were not good at school, or they are too old, or whatever it is. These students are getting jobs in the best company in the Valley. And we have done this with a staff of 15 people. So just to give you an idea of you know the scale of the school and the beauty of it is that we are headquarters, so we have to develop the curriculum and the fundraising and the strategy of the school and you know the press and so on. But if we were to open other schools, which we are trying to do, we are working on doing in the US and internationally, we would not need as much staff. And the beauty of it is that we can use this same type of education anywhere in the world with very low staff and provide this type of education to the most, which is ultimately the goal of the school.